What's up everyone, Patrick here again, and in today's video I'll be doing another VPN feature comparison of both ExpressVPN and NordVPN and the available protocols for each. Now a VPN just stands for Virtual Private Network, and it simply allows you to connect to a server in a different location before then connecting to your destination online, effectively masking your IP address to help you remain anonymous online. And protocols for VPNs are just the different methods for connecting to these servers. This is handled on the back end, but you can select specific ones using both of these services. Now, the universally used VPN protocol is called Open VPN, and both of these services provide that, but each of these services also have their own proprietary VPN protocols, which can prioritize security and speed and are utilizing some of the newer technologies out there. So let's jump in and take a look at both NordVPN and ExpressVPN and the protocols they have to offer. Okay, so starting off with NordVPN, we can open up the desktop app, and we're going to be focused on opening up those protocol settings. So we'll click on the gear icon at the very top of the window, and this will open up our general settings, but we're going to click on Auto Connect on the left-hand side. Now, by default, NordVPN has an Auto Connect setting that determines not just the best region and best server within that region to connect to, but also the best protocol. So in order to dive in and get a look at some of the available protocols through NordVPN and change them for ourselves, we'll want to head over to the Choose a VPN protocol and server automatically and turn that off. And then this will give us two different drop-down menus where you can either auto connect to a specific server and then the VPN protocol, which is what we're focused on here. Now, as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, OpenVPN is one of the most widely used VPN protocols, but NordVPN has three available to choose from. So they've got two different versions of the OpenVPN, but then they've got their own proprietary one, which I mentioned before, called NordLynx. Now, this one has been tailored specifically for the NordVPN platform, so it works better with their hardware than OpenVPN might, because OpenVPN is just a general protocol. Now, it works great, and it's become the standard throughout the entire world as far as that VPN protocol goes, but because Nord knows what's going on their backend and with their servers and hardware, they've developed their own protocol that is more efficient and more secure specifically on their platform. So all you have to do is select the VPN protocol you prefer from here and back out, and then when you connect next time, it will automatically use that protocol. Now opening up the ExpressVPN desktop app, you can see I'm not connected yet. And same thing, we're going to head over to the protocols. So we'll click on the three bars at the top left and go down to options. And this will bring up a second window. Now this window will have all of our general settings in here, but there's also a protocol tab, which is what we'll click on. And from here you can see it's got an automatic, which is recommended protocol. And it's just like that quick connect on NordVPN where it finds the best one for the server or region you're connecting to and uses that protocol. Or you can go in and manually choose your own, which as you can see, there's the two different versions, the UDP and TCP versions of OpenVPN, the IKEv2, L2TP, and Lightway. Now, L2TP, as you can see right here, it even says lower security, and then IKEv2 even says in its description that it's fast, but it doesn't work on all networks, which is one of the downsides. Where OpenVPN is usually a generally cast net, it can work with almost all servers, but referencing that proprietary protocol used by ExpressVPN, theirs is called Lightway. So where you had NordVPN's NordLynx protocol, ExpressVPN has their Lightway protocol. And clicking on any one of these will allow you to then switch over to that protocol next time you connect by just hitting that connect button, and it will automatically use that protocol unless, of course, that protocol is not supported by the servers you're trying to connect to in the instance of IKEv2 and some of the other protocols that aren't used as widely. You now have a clear understanding of what both NordVPN and ExpressVPN can offer as far as protocols come, and what those protocols can do for you, and how to switch to them. Now, again, these are both fantastic VPN services, but depending on your location or what works best for you, you might want to try out one and then give the other one a try, because they both do offer that 30-day money-back guarantee, so you never have to worry about being stuck with a service that just isn't right for you. And of course, I will include a link to both NordVPN and ExpressVPN down in the description, so be sure to check out those links below. And as always, if you found this video helpful, give it a like and subscribe to the channel to check out more content just like this, hitting that bell so you get notified every time we post a new one. And as always, I want to thank you for watching.